Hello students, welcome to 12th lecture of Chemical Bonding and Molecular Structure. In previous lecture, we discussed about overlapping of orbitals in two different ways. We observed that if orbitals overlap with each other on same axis, then it will form stronger sigma bondings. And if two orbitals are parallel with each other and then they overlap with each other, then they will create comparatively weaker pi bond. First bond between two atoms will be always sigma bondings, and later if double or triple bond is there, then second and third bond will be pi bonds. So now we have to consider this sigma and pi bonds in next topic, which is hybridization. So let us talk about hybridization in detail. In order to explain the characteristic geometrical shape of polyatomic molecules like CH4, NH3 and H2O, etc., Pauling introduced a concept of hybridization. According to him, atomic orbitals combine to form new set of equivalent orbitals known as hybrid orbitals. Now, equivalent, that means initially in atomic state, maybe orbitals have different energies or different type of shape and orientations. During the bond formation, these orbitals will create hybrid orbitals. That means we are talking about two different atoms combining with each other. Initially, all of the separate atomic orbitals will be different in size, shape and energies. But when they form molecules, then they will create hybrid orbitals which will be equivalent. That means before reaction they may be different, but after attachment with each other or after the overlapping, their energies, orientations or sizes will be same. That's why it is called equivalent orbitals. Unlike pure orbitals, the hybrid orbitals are used in bond formation. The phenomenon is called hybridization, which can be defined as process of intermixing of the orbitals of slightly different energies so as to redistribute their energies, resulting in the formation of new sets of orbitals of equivalent energies and shape. As for example, suppose before reaction we are talking about just two orbitals. Suppose bond is formed in s orbital and p orbital. So as we know, shape of s orbital is spherical, shape of p orbital is dumbbell shape. But when these two orbitals participate in bond formation, then their shapes will be similar. That means shapes will change. Energy of s orbital is lower than p orbital, it will increase. Energy of s orbital will slightly increase, energy of p orbital will slightly decrease, and eventually they will become almost equal or close to each other. So they will redefine themselves, they will change their energy, they will change their shape, they will change their orientation, and they will try to be same as it can be, so that bond formation can occur. So, for example, when 2s and 2p orbitals of carbon hybridizes, there is formation of 4 new sp3 hybrid orbitals. Now, this term sp3 is very important. So, it represents we have 1 s orbital and 3 p orbitals in bond formation. So, total we have 4 orbitals. And initially, energy of s orbital will be comparatively less than p orbital, okay, but after bond formation or after hybridization, all of them will become equal. That means energy of 1 s orbital and energy of 1 p orbital in molecule of carbon, it will be same in size, shape and orientation will be almost equal. So, salient feature of hybridization. The main features of hybridization are as under. The number of hybrid orbitals is equal to the number of atomic orbitals that gets hybridized. So that means number of atomic orbitals in total is equal to number of hybridized orbitals. They will be same. That means no orbitals will be produced and no orbitals will be removed. All of them will be still present in molecular form. The hybridization orbital are always equivalent in energy and shape, okay, as we discussed already. The hybrid orbitals are more effective in forming stable bonds than the pure atomic orbital. Now keep in mind, these orbitals changes their shape, so do not assume them as a solid rigid shapes. They are flexible shape, we can assume it like balloons. Okay, balloons, we know that they can change their shape. If we apply pressure on them, then they will change their shape. If we apply pressure inside them, they will expand. So these orbitals are one type of clouds in which electrons will be present. So it can be wise to think that they can change their shapes. Okay, we know that clouds have no definite shape. Just like that, they do not have rigid shapes as well. They can change their shape depending on their atmosphere. Fourth point, the hybrid orbitals are directed in space in some preferred direction to have minimum repulsion between the electron pairs and thus a stable arrangement. Therefore, the type of hybridization indicates the geometry of molecule. Now, just like as mentioned earlier in VSREP theory, valential electron pair repulsion theory, bonding electrons will try to move away from each other so that repulsion can be minimized. Okay, just like that, in this case, hybrid orbitals will try to move away from each other because this orbital contains electrons and electrons will repel other electrons because of similar charges. So they will try to move away from each other just like discussed in Vespa theory so that repulsion can be minimized and stability can be increased. Now, next point is important conditions for hybridization. First, the orbital present in the valence shell of atoms are hybridized. Second, the orbital undergoes hybridization should have almost equal energy. That means orbitals present in outermost shell will be hybridized, or we can say that valence electrons will participate in hybridization. Second point, the orbitals undergoing hybridization should have almost equal energy. Their energy gap should be limited. If they have comparatively large energy gap, then we cannot use them in hybridization because in hybridization their energies will be almost equal. And it is possible when they have comparatively minor gap in energy before. That means between 2s and 2p orbitals, there is an energy gap, but this energy gap is comparatively very less. That's why they can participate in bond formation. And third point, promotion of electron is not essential condition prior to hybridization. Now, promotion of electron, that means shifting of electron from lower energy orbit to higher energy orbit. It is not necessary, but it can be used in some cases. That means we will observe that in certain cases, we will transfer electron of lower energy orbit into higher energy orbit to gain or to achieve hybridization. Fourth point is, it is not necessary that only half-filled orbitals participate in hybridization. In some cases, even filled orbitals of valence shell take part in hybridization. That means usually bond formation occurs between partially filled orbitals. That means suppose if we assume that electron of 2s is single, that means 2s can occupy up to 2 electrons, but it contains only single electron, then that orbital can participate in bond formation. But usually if it contains 2 electrons, then it has no need to participate in reaction because it is fully filled, that's why it is stable. And stable things do not participate in reaction or they do not show reactivity. But in hybridization, we will see that in certain cases, orbitals having fully filled with electrons will participate in hybridization as well. Now let us talk about the types of hybridization and their examples. Now keep in mind, we are talking about a geometrical shape based on hybridization. So each and every hybridization have fixed type of shape. Okay, and shape, that means we are talking about arrangement of electrons around the central atom. Actual shape and arrangement of electrons will be different as we discussed in VSREP theory. We observe that when, let us assume an example of methane. In methane, around the carbon we have 4 electron pairs, and to minimize the repulsion, all of these 4 electron pairs will be present at 109.28 angle. That means they will form tetrahedral shape. But if you replace one of the bond pair with lone pair, then shape will be pyramidal. If you change one more electron pair, then shape will be angular, like water molecule. Okay, so same thing can be applicable in this case as well. So our first type of hybridization is sp hybridization. Now we can directly predict which orbitals will participate from the name of the hybridization. So as the name suggests, sp, that means one s orbital and one p orbital will participate in bond formation or in hybridization. So formation of two equivalent sp hybridized orbitals will be produced. As a result, the suitable orbitals of sp hybridization are s and pz. Okay, so first pz orbital will participate in reaction, because as mentioned earlier, orbitals present on same axis will form sigma bonding. So we will consider z orbital as a common axis, or z axis as a common axis for two different atoms. So first bond will be formed between s and pz orbital. This hybridization has 50% characteristics of each, that means 50% s character and 50% p character. Okay, so total number of orbitals are 2, and out of 2, one is s orbital and second is p orbital. So that means both of them contributes 50% in this type of bond formation or hybridization. Now, such a molecule in which the central atom is sp hybridized and linked directly to two other central atoms possesses linear geometry. That means this molecule will be linear. That means suppose we have atom A, and this atom A contains sp characteristics or hybridization, then shape of this molecule will be something like this. Okay, suppose we have AB2 molecule, then hybridization of A is sp3, then shape of molecule will be something like this. It will be linear. Now keep in mind, each and every atom present in molecule have their own separate hybridization. That means this A atom contains sp hybridization. It won't apply to these B atoms. Hybridization of B may be or may not be sp. It depends on their electronic configuration, and we will talk about that in upcoming points. Okay, we will discuss some examples so that these points can be cleared. But just keep in mind, each and every atom present in molecule have their own separate hybridization, no matter how big or small a molecule is. So the two sp hybrid points in the opposite direction along the z axis, with projecting positive lobes and very small negative lobes, which provides more effective overlapping, resulting in the formation of stronger bonds. So that means this point says, before reaction or hybridization, suppose we have one s orbital having shape something like this and one pz orbital having shape something like this. But during the bond formation or after the hybridization, that means we are talking about sp hybridization, both of them will change their shape accordingly. Shape of s orbital will change in something like this manner, having larger positive lobe and smaller negative lobe. Similar situation will be observed for p orbital, having larger positive lobe and smaller negative lobe. Both of them will have same type of shape, and these positive lobes will combine with other atoms, and hybridization occurs. Okay, so this type of situation occurs. Now just assume center of atom is present here, that means these two are placed on top of each other. But to simplify the explanation, we represented it separately. Okay, but they are actually present on each other. Now as for example, BeCl2 has sp hybridization. The ground state electronic configuration of Be, we are talking about central atom Be. For chlorine, hybridization may be different. Okay, we will talk about it after we discuss all of the hybridization. So BeCl2, the ground state electronic configuration of Be is 1s2, 2s2, because it is element number 4. So it contains 4 electrons. In excited state, one of the 2s electron is promoted to 2p orbital, that means in 2pz orbital, and this is the reason for its divalency, that means nature of forming two different bonds. 1 2s and 1 2p orbital gets hybridized to form 2 sp hybridized orbitals. These 2 sp hybridized orbitals are oriented in opposite direction, forming angle of 180 degree. Each of the sp hybridized orbitals overlaps with the 2p orbital of chlorine actually and form 2 BeCl sigma bonds. This is shown in figure 4.10. So as we can see, in figure A we have s orbital which is spherical, and in adjacent figure we have pz orbital. When these two orbitals combines with each other in hybridization, it will change their shape. So as mentioned earlier, earlier shape of s orbital is something like this. Later it will give us larger sized positive lobe and smaller sized negative lobe. Okay, so which is mentioned here, this is larger sized positive lobe and smaller sized negative lobe. Similarly, shape of pz orbital will change. It will give us larger sized positive lobe and smaller sized negative lobe, which is mentioned here. We have larger sized positive lobe and smaller sized negative lobe. So it is sp hybridized orbital of BE. Now this positive lobe will combine with pz orbitals of chlorines, as we can see in this final formation. Okay, so pz orbital of first chlorine and second chlorine will be shared to form sigma bonding. That means they will overlap to form sigma bonding with BE, and you will get BeCl2. Now as mentioned earlier, initial electronic configuration of BE is 1s2 2s2, and it contains 0 electrons in 2p orbital. Okay, so if orbital is empty, then no need to mention it during the electronic configuration. But if, as you can see, second number orbit is present, then all of the orbitals of second number or second principal quantum number will be present. That means, suppose you have 3s1 type of electronic configuration, that means our principal quantum number is 3. So this atom contains all of the orbitals of principal quantum number 3, or all of the possible L value of principal quantum number n. That means it also contains 3p orbital and it also contains 3d orbital. But these orbitals are empty, so no need to mention it, but they will be present if required. So initial electronic configuration of BE is 1s2 2s2 and it contains 0 electron in 2p. During the hybridization, we can say that it shows excited state of BE. Star sign represents excited state. So inner orbital electrons do not participate in bond formation. Only outermost orbitals or valence orbitals do participate. So 1s orbitals do not participate in this case. So electron of 2s will jump from 2 to 2p z. Now earlier it contains 2 electrons, now it has only 1. One of the electron is now present in 2pz orbital. So now we have 2 partially filled orbitals, and these partially filled orbitals will combine with 2pz orbitals of chlorine, and they will form 2 sigma bonds, which can be visualized in these images. Now next type of hybridization is sp2 hybridization. So as the name suggests, it contains 1s orbital and 2 different p orbitals. Okay, so total number of orbitals will be 3. So in this hybridization, there is involvement of 1s and 2p orbitals in order to form 3 equivalent sp2 hybridized orbital, for example BCl3 molecule. The ground state electronic configuration of the central boron atom is 1s2, 2s2 and 2p1. So total 3 electrons are present in outermost 2 orbit. So valence orbit contains total 3 electrons, 2 in s orbital, 1 in p orbital. So in excited state, one of the 2s electron is promoted to vacant 2p orbital. As a result, boron has 3 unpaired electrons. These 3 orbitals, 1 2s and 2p hybridized, to form 3sp2 hybridized orbital. The 3 hybrid orbitals so formed are oriented in trigonal panel arrangement and overlap with 2p orbitals of chlorine to form 3 BCl bonds. Now keep in mind, all of the arrangement will be exactly as same as mentioned in Vespa theory. As mentioned in those theory, if you have two electron pairs, then molecule will be linear, because to reduce the repulsion, these two electron pairs will align with each other with 180 degree angle. If you have three of them, then they will form 120 degree angle. And similarly, if you have four of them, then they will form tetrahedral shape. Same pattern will be observed in this case, that means in case of hybridization. Instead of electron pair, we will talk about orbitals. So here we have three orbitals, that means they will align in the corner of planar triangle. So it can reduce the repulsion. So angle will be 120 degree. And if you want to talk about the percentage of characteristics or character, then in sp2 hybridization we have one s orbital and two p orbital, total three. So three, that means 100%, then one, that means 33.33%. so s characteristics of sp2 is 33.33, and p characteristics obviously it will be 66.66%, because 3 is equal to 100% and 2 is equal to 66.66%. Visual representation of this type of formation is, as we can see in this case, we have one s orbital mentioned here, a spherical s orbital present at the center. Then we have py orbital, that means orbital present on y axis. So this will be the py orbital. And next, pz orbital, it will be present here. Okay, this will be our pz orbital. Initially all of them contains maybe different energies and different shapes, but after the hybridization they will be equivalent. So when hybridization occurs, their positive lobes will be larger in size and negative lobes will reduce, and all of these three orbitals will redesign themselves, so you will get this type of shape. Let us say this will be our s orbital, which has larger positive lobe and smaller negative lobes. Initially it s orbitals don't have any kind of lobes, but after the hybridization they will change their shape. This will be, let us say, our py orbital, and this will be our pz orbital, okay, with larger positive lobes and smaller negative lobes. And their positive lobes will combine with chlorine's pz orbitals. They will overlap with each other to form three sigma bonds, as we can see in this image. Next one is sp3 hybridization. So as the name suggests, we have one s orbital and three p orbitals. So all of them will be used, px, py and pz, all of them will be used in this type of hybridization. So example, we can take an example of one of the most common molecule, methane molecule. So methane has sp3 hybridization. It contains total four orbitals. We are talking about central atom carbon. So it contains total four orbitals, one s orbital and three p orbital. So all of them will change their shape. As we discussed earlier, they will have larger sized positive lobes and smaller sized negative lobes. So this will be initial shape. At the center we have s orbital spherical, then we have pz orbital arranged like this, px orbital arranged like this, and py orbital arranged like this. Okay, so all of them has different type of shapes and energies, and when they hybridized they will give us this type of shape with larger sized positive lobes. Negative lobes are not indicated in this case, but they will be present. And again, keep in mind, in case of orbitals having these type of lobes, plus and minus signs do not represent positive or negative charges. They represent probability of electron. That means, suppose we have two different lobes of pz orbital, then plus sign represents you will find electron in that lobe. Minus sign represents you won't find electron in negative lobe. So plus and minus signs actually represents probability of finding electron. Plus indicates there is high probability of finding electron. Minus represents there is very low probability of finding electron. So during the hybridization, after the hybridization actually, all the sp3 hybridized orbitals have equal energy. That means they will be equivalent energies and shape. And if we talk about the characteristics, then we have total 4 orbitals. Out of 4, only one is s orbital. So s character is 25%. And out of 4, 3 are p orbitals. So 75% p characteristics is present. Now, as we discussed earlier, we have total 4 orbitals. If you have 4 orbitals, then suitable shape of this 4 orbital will be tetrahedral, so that repulsion will be minimized. So methane molecule is tetrahedral, so it explains. But what about some other molecule like NH3 or H2O or even HF? They all of them have different type of shapes, but same type of hybridization. Keep in mind, CH4, NH3, H2O and HF, all of these molecules contains same type of hybridization, which is sp3 hybridization. So why they contains different shape? Shape of CH3 is tetrahedral, shape of NH3 is pyramidal, shape of H2O is angular, and shape of HF is linear. So what is the reason behind it, and how you can find hybridization of given molecule based on their electronic configuration, using their electronic configuration? Okay, so we will talk about it. So as mentioned here, NH3, the valence shell, outer shell electronic configuration of nitrogen in the NH3 is, during the ground state, it will be 2s2, 2px1, 2py1, 2pz1. That means all of the 3 p orbitals contains one electron in each. Having 3 unpaired electrons in sp3 hybridized orbitals and a lone pair electron is present in the fourth one. That means 3 orbitals of sp3 hybridization contain single electron. That means 3 p orbitals, but fourth s orbital is fully filled. It contains 2 electrons. So s orbital is already fully filled, so that means it won't form bond with other element, but it will be present there, and it also contributes in hybridization. So these 3 hybrid orbitals overlaps with 1s orbital of hydrogen atom to form 3 NH sigma bonds. We know that the force of repulsion between the lone pair and a bond pair is more than the force of repulsion between 2 bond pairs. That means in NH3 we have total 4 electron pair. One is non-bonding electron pair and 3 is bonding electron pair. That means nitrogen shares its electron pair with hydrogen. That means, let us understand it like this. Initial electronic configuration of nitrogen is 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. That means it contains 2 electrons in s orbital and 3 electrons in p orbital, and all of them will be single in p orbital. So to fulfill its requirement or to fulfill its octet, nitrogen shares 3 electrons with 3 different hydrogens like this. So in outermost orbit of nitrogen we have total 4 electron pair. In out of 4, one is non-bonding and 3 of them are bonding electron pair. Okay, so this non-bonding electron pair and all of these 3 bonding electron pair. Now this second electron in each p orbital belongs to hydrogen. It shares its electron with nitrogen, so that requirement of nitrogen will be fulfilled. So that's how we have total 4 electron pairs around the nitrogen, and non-bonding electron pair repels highest. That means highest repulsion will be observed from this non-bonding electron pair, and then second repulsion will arise between this bonding electron pair. But bonding electron pairs repels each other comparatively weakly if we compare it with non-bonding electron pair. So we have 4 different electron pairs, so arrangement of these electron pairs will be tetrahedral, but these non-bonding electron pair actually do not contribute in shape of molecules. So simply we can assume that we have tetrahedral shape of nitrogen, something like this. But here we have one non-bonding electron pairs which do not contribute in actual shape of molecule. That means actual shape of molecule finally will be pyramidal. Okay, so this will be our shape of molecule, which is pyramidal. Now, because of the higher repulsion of non-bonding electron pair, thus molecule gets distorted and the bond angle is reduced to 107 from 109.5. The geometry of such molecule will be pyramidal as shown in image. Okay, so as we can see in this image, arrangement of electron pair will be tetrahedral, but shape of molecule will be pyramidal. So in case of H2O molecule, the four oxygen orbitals 2s and 3 2p orbital undergoes sp3 hybridization just like before, forming four sp3 hybridized orbital, out of which two contains one electron of each and two are already fully filled with electron. So it will be something like this. So let us talk about it in detail. So electronic configuration of oxygen will be 1s2 2p2 2p4. That means it contains two electron in s orbital and four electron in p orbital, like this. So it contains two lone pair of electrons. So obviously these two single electrons will be shared with two other hydrogen atoms, and hydrogen will provide one electron of it, so that octet of oxygen will be complete. So as we can see, we have four electron pairs in outermost orbital. Out of two are non-bonding electron pair and two are bonding electron pair. So arrangement of electron pair will be tetrahedral around the oxygen, that means something like this. But these two non-bonding electron pair do not contribute in shape of molecule, that's why shape of molecule will be angular. Okay, hydrogen will be attached here, so this will be the shape of molecule. And now, as mentioned earlier, repulsion between this non-bonding electron pair will be strong, that's why this angle will be reduced. It won't be 109.5, it will be 104.28 or 104.5. Now let's talk about how to identify hybridization. Okay, so as mentioned earlier, we have some examples. As for example, CH4, which has electronic configuration something like this. We have one single electron in s orbital and three single electron in p orbital, and with all of these four orbital, one hydrogen will be attached and it will provide one electron of each. So CH4 molecule contains four bonding electron pairs. Okay, all of these four pairs are bonding electron pairs. In case of NH3, situation will be slightly different. It already contains one electron pair and three single electron. These three single electron will be shared with hydrogen, so that octet of nitrogen will be complete. But in this case, we have one non-bonding electron pair and three bonding electron pairs. In case of H2O, oxygen contains two electrons in s and four electrons in p orbital, so this two single electrons will be shared with two different hydrogens. So in this case, we have two non-bonding and two bonding orbitals. But as mentioned, all of them contains sp3 hybridization. So how can we identify hybridization from the electronic configuration? So just keep in mind, you need to count electron pairs. So we have total three different type of electron pairs in the molecule. One will be non-bonding electron pair, one will be bonding electron pair, and bonding electron pair again has two different types, sigma bonding and pi bonding, as discussed earlier. So you have to count non-bonding electron pairs and sigma bonding pairs in hybridization, and you have to ignore pi electron pairs. We will talk about these pi electron pairs in next lecture. But right now, as we can see here, we have non-bonding and sigma bondings only. All of these single bonds represents they are sigma bonds. If we have double bonds, then one of them will be sigma, second one will be pi. If you have triple bonds, then one of them will be sigma and two of them will be pi. But in this case, we do not have any pi bonds, so no need to talk about it in this point. So just count the non-bonding electron pairs and sigma bonding electron pairs, and it will give us hybridization as mentioned here. Suppose if you want to talk about CH4, then as we can see, all of them are sigma bonds. That means all of them are bond pairs and they are sigma. So you have to count one electron pair present in s orbital and three electron pairs, sigma bonded electron pairs in p orbital. We have three electron pairs in p, so hybridization will be sp3. Similarly, if you want to talk about BCl3 as mentioned in earlier example, previous example, then first electronic configuration of boron, 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. So we have two electrons in s orbital, one electron in p orbital. So this s orbital electron will jump in p orbital. So now we have three single electrons. All of these three single electrons will combine with chlorine, and chlorine shares electron with them, and all of these bonds are sigma bonds. So we have one bonding electron, sigma bonded electron pair in s orbital and two in p orbital. So hybridization will be sp2. In next lecture we will talk about pi electron pairs, and then we will discuss about some random molecules and we will try to find their hybridization. If you find any difficulty up to this point, feel free to ask. We will discuss it in detail. Thank you.